the endless dialogue, negotiation and talks in the Niger Delta. When this jamboree started and Oshibanjo, the vice president of the Nigerian state, visited Oproza, I came out to say the obvious. And a lot of people were blinded by the needs of their belly and their pockets. So all sorts of criticism, all sorts of name calling, some people called for my arrest as if I'll be afraid. And all the ulabula, it all ended. And they set up pound there. But let me try to reflect back and lay the foundation of how pound there came into being. I was invited by General Boro, the advisor to the president of Niger Delta, and the coordinator of the presidential amnesty program. He invited me to be at a meeting that is being organized by his department and the NDDC at Uyo. And Alawus Raigbe came to my house several times and called me on the phone several times to persuade me to be part of the meeting. And I told them I wasn't going to be there because there was no need. There's no need to try to hold a talk with somebody who is blind, who is deaf and dumb. Even sign language would not help in such a situation because he cannot see, he cannot hear, and he cannot talk. So they went. My wife, Mama Luta, Caroline, Dokwasare, was invited to the meeting behind my back. And after the meeting, when she came, when she was briefing me, I said, "Sweetheart, please, you have to choose between your marriage and these meetings." And my wife made a choice. She chose me. And she went back to Germany, where she resides. A lot of my senior friends, Tiko Goriba and others, lampooned me. They called me and said she was there on her own right of recognition. She was a student union, a Joy student union leader. She was woman leader of the Joy Youth Council, IYC. She was there on self-recognizance. And I said, there is nobody who will see my wife and say she was not representing me. And so, leave my wife. My wife is just an individual. Leave her alone. Go on with the negotiation. Whatever you decide, okay, if it bring good, Allahu Akbar. If it fails, then you have confirmed my fears. So they continued with their negotiation, their dialogue. How can you dialogue with people in the graveyard? How can you go to dialogue and hold a conference in the graveyard? Just you and the graves? That is what is going on. Because people are there, they say they are dialoguing. They are reducing the whole gamut of the Ijaw struggle. I'm not talking of Niger Delta struggle, because that was what I said and the interview and a lot of people. No, I am talking of the Ijaw struggle. I am first a Calabari Ijaw man, then an Ijaw man, then whatever else. I am talking of the Ijaw struggle. They've reduced the whole gamut of the Ijaw struggle to just maritime university and payment of amnesty students there are scholarships for students in the university and so on. Wow, this is so disappointing. Our struggle is way, 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 way beyond these things. It's even an insult on us. Was the University of Abuja established after a series of dialogue? Why would the people of Okerenkoko not have the same rights with the people of Dusewa, with the people of Lagos, with the people of Otuake, with the people of Choba? Why would they not have the same right? If they are all citizens of Nigeria, if the university is good to be cited at Gwagalada or wherever in Abuja, then it is also the right of the people of Okroza, the right of the people of Okerenkoko to have a university cited in Okerenkoko or Okroza. I don't understand this special attachment if everything is okay. But people are meeting, people are struggling for their name to be included in a process that is going nowhere, in a process that is a senseless jamboree. Then one traditional ruler one day called me. The Pere of Assembly called me and started to tell me, Clark, they failed, this one they failed. In the first place, when the meeting started, Clark was not there. The meeting started, Clark was not there. I think some people went and brought him in to have more leverage and so on and so forth. But if I were Clark, I have achieved everything. What is all this craze about going to talk with Buhari? Who is Buhari in the first place? It beats my imagination. And I mean, a tiger, a bo kalamake bo ketujo krande vevete ni kagbotia. I mean, Oyibo Brasimbi. Clark, you have been state commissioner, federal commissioner, senator, so what do you need? In all this, you were there before Buhari came to become a federal commissioner for petroleum resources, where $2.8 billion grew wings and flew away. So if at your age, Baba Clark, you are still struggling to... I don't understand though. Even me. So when they talk, I say, I don't want to belong. I don't know. I know where it will arrive at. It will arrive at no. Even if the Maritime University eventually takes off, it will not be a university at all. It will not be a university at all. That's the truth of the matter. So today now, the Avengers have come back to avenge again. Why did you stop in the first place? You know, people play with us. People laugh at us. We become laughing stock and all the drama associated. Why did you stop? You knew the destination this thing will surely arrive at. And we know. Were you just pretending? Did you start having fatigue? And all of a sudden you stop and now you come back and you think that the people will give you the same sort of support that they gave you before. You have eroded the confidence of the people. So whatever you do now, people will be lukewarm about what you are doing. And that's the truth of the matter. So when you are doing something, you do it consistently. So when you say operation, no mercy. Why did you show mercy in the first place? So all our struggle is just to have a university at Okerenkoko. It's just to have amnesty. How many people are in the amnesty program? It's just to pay amnesty students? It's just to talk about East-West Road? No. That's not our struggle. Our struggle is to take back our stolen sovereignty. That is our struggle. So all these ones, restructure, rebuilding, redesign, architects, what do they call them? Redesign the structure, the upside down, all of them. No. The sum total of our struggle is this. We want to take, whether they like it or not, we want to take back our stolen sovereignty.